Welcome to Third Quarter Corona. I'm Natalie.
And I'm Taylor.
And this is... Hey seniors, the Senior Class Council wants you to submit a design for the Class of 2024 senior shirts. The design is due by January 31st.
You can submit the design through the Google form that can be found on the Class of 2024 Instagram account.
Are you interested in learning more about your strengths, weaknesses, and potential for future success? The Armed Services Vocational Amputee Battery is the most widely used multiple amputee test battery in the world. The ASVAB provides you with career information for various civilian and military occupations and is an indicator for success in future endeavors, whether you choose to go to college, vocational school, or military career. The test is going to be administered on Wednesday, January 17th. If you'd like to take the test, please visit the counseling office to register.
Attention seniors, the FAFSA is now open for you and your parents to complete in order to receive financial aid for college. If you have any questions regarding the FAFSA, our new College Connect advisor, Naomi Sanders, will be in the counseling office Tuesdays, Wednesdays, and Thursdays from 8 a.m. to 3 p.m. to help. We've got some important info about the upcoming lip sync battles.
Keep watching to find out more.
Get ready, Corona, because our fifth annual staff lip sync battles are coming up. Teachers, if you want to participate, make sure to email Mr. Forbes by next Friday, January 19th, and we'll assemble a student team for you. Alternatively, students, we need you to encourage teachers to participate. Just make sure they also email Mr. Forbes. What's the prize? A $500 donation to any charity of the winner's choice. Oh, and you know, bragging rights for winning lip sync battles. The first round out of seven will be aired on February 2nd, and each round afterwards leading up to the finals will also be aired on cdstv. And our final round will be played live at the spring assembly. Looking forward to seeing you teachers lip sync for your lives.
Hey Corona, I'm Hannah.
And I'm Greg.
And this is your concert calendar for January, and we're inside because it's too cold.
So first, on the 11th, we have Slaughter Beach Dog at the Crescent Ballroom, and then on the 19th and the 20th, we have the Eagles at Footprint Center. On the 20th, we have Black Flag at the Marquee Theater, and on the 23rd, we have Holding Absence at the Nile Theater.
And for the locals, on the 13th, we have Seahorse Choke at Ground Zero Studios, and on the 20th, we have Negative 32 at the RXC House. On the 24th, we have Significant Others at the Rebel Lounge, and on the 27th, we have Suppressor at the Ground Zero Studios. And that's your concert calendar for the month of January. Hopefully we'll see you at some of these concerts.
If you're planning on taking a Real Salado dual enrollment course in the spring, enrollment has opened. Please log into your account and add the course ID given to you by your teacher.
You can also find the course codes on the dual enrollment website. Last day to enroll is February 12th.
Do not wait until February since there are placement tests that need to be taken. Please see Ms. Fleming in E269 or Ms. Schmidt in E281 if you have any questions.
Hey gamers, do you play Smash Brothers or Rocket League? The esports team is looking for you. There will be a meeting next Thursday, January 18th, in room E52 after school. If you have any questions, please contact Mr. Castillo.
Good luck to our seniors in CompGov as they participate in the We the People State competition at MCC today. Stay tuned for some CDSTV original content.
If you're at all familiar with the reggaeton genre, you've most likely heard the name Tiny before, but you may not know who he is or what he does. He's a Puerto Rican producer and songwriter who has been present in the genre for almost two decades. He's made a name for himself by producing hits for artists like J Balvin, Anuel AA, and of course the legendary Bad Bunny. In June of 2023, he released his highly anticipated debut album, Tata, which has since made number 3 on Rolling Stone's Top Albums of 2023 chart and number 1 on his chart for Top Spanish Language Albums of the same year. But is it worth the hype? Or is it just another album made to please critics and cash in on the genre's success? Let's find out. Tata released consisting of 19 songs, with one more added later on. The album has a futuristic feeling to it, with each song taking you on a different journey. Songs like Mojave Ghost with Bad Bunny and Volver with Skrillex, Forte, and Rauw Alejandro take you through the mind of someone longing for their past lover. Once y Once with Sech and Evax describes someone who's been wronged by their past relationship, and Lo Siento Bebe starts as someone asking for a chance and then shifts to the other perspective who's had it with love and believes Cupid is nothing more than a liar. Each song's journey is amplified by Tiny's incredible production, which pushes these artists into territory many of them haven't been before. There's not a single point in this album where it feels repetitive. Tiny's range of sounds keeps the album feeling fresh for the entire hour and 4 minute journey, and his unexpected yet genius production keeps you on your toes because you never know when the beat will stop or switch. Tiny was not playing around when it came to making this 3-year project of an album. He brought out some of the biggest names in reggaeton to be featured here, both old and new. Rising star Young Miko makes 2 appearances on this album, reggaeton legend Bad Bunny appears 3 times, and industry veterans Daddy Yankee and Arcángel both make their respective appearances as well. Data by Tiny is an album that somehow manages to redefine reggaeton while also sticking to its roots. With an all-star cast of voices combined with Tiny's legendary production, Data can be best described as reggaeton perfection. Anyone who likes reggaeton, or any of the artists featured on this album, will find something they like here. I recommend you give this album a listen, even if you don't speak Spanish, because it truly is a masterpiece. Thanks for watching, Corona. See you next time.
In the toughest tournament in New Mexico, Aztec Wrestling finished 9th as a team and got medals from Kevin Santiago, Tevor Ham, Miranda Ellsworth, Joel Arias, and a runner-up finish from Aiden Odom.
The Aztecs competed in California with Joel Arias, Kevin Santiago, Lucas Conrad, Braden Johnson-Brown, Mikey Winwacker, and Aiden Odom, all bringing home medals. The wrestling team is currently 14-1. Go Aztec Wrestling!
Interested in joining the Taste Buds After School Club for the spring semester? We meet on Tuesdays from 2:30 to 4:30 and the cost is $30. Contact Chef Williamson for more details.
Let's enter creative and check out our Minecraft weather forecast.
Hello Corona, this is your weekend weather forecast. On Friday, it's going to be sunny with a high of 57 degrees and a low of 36 degrees. On Saturday, it's going to be mostly sunny with a high of 62 degrees and a low of 41 degrees. On Sunday, it's going to be mostly sunny with a high of 64 degrees and a low of 40 degrees. On Monday, it'll be mostly sunny with a high of 65 degrees and a low of 36 degrees. Thank you for watching, Corona. This was your weekend weather forecast.
Compared to heroin, fentanyl is at least 50 times more potent. Fentanyl is also 100 times more potent than morphine, an opioid that is used to treat pain.
Illegal fentanyl is sold in the following forms: as a powder, dropped on a blotter paper like small candies, in eyedroppers or nasal sprays, or made into pills that look like real prescription opioids.
Counterfeit fentanyl is being mixed with other drugs. This is especially dangerous because people are often unaware that fentanyl has been added.
60% counterfeit pills tested contain lethal traces of fentanyl.
A lethal dose of fentanyl can be as small as just 2 grains of rice.
It is nearly impossible to tell if a pill has been laced or not just by looking at it alone. Testing strips can help identify fentanyl, but they cannot be trusted for sure.
With fentanyl, there may not be a second chance.
She composed for Mary J. Blige, is the idol of Nicki Minaj, and made rappers know they like Kendrick Lamar. We're talking about none other than Miss Lauryn Hill.
Lauryn Noelle Hill is an American rapper, record producer, and actress known for her passionate voice which propelled her to the top of the hip-hop charts in the late 90s, from being featured in several movies and TV shows to being the first rap artist to win Album of the Year. Miss Hill broke obstacles others couldn't. Lauryn Hill was born on May 26, 1975 in East Orange, New Jersey. From an early age, Lauryn enjoyed school, but music did a lot more for her than anything else. She would spend tons of time listening to records in her room, absorbing 60s and 70s soul. Lauryn would take any chance she would get to perform. At just age 13, she was a contestant on the famous live show Amateur Night at the Apollo and was booed. But as she continued to sing, the crowd came along and clapped her on in the end, not knowing they were witnessing the beginning of history. Just a few years later, Miss Hill would make another public appearance as a dancer in MC Lyte's music video, Poor Georgie. At Lawrence Local High School in Maplewood, New Jersey, Prah Coswell Michelle, aka Praz, approached Miss Hill about joining their hip-hop group The Fugees. Later introducing her to Wyclef Jean, Lauryn became one of the group's songwriters, as well as one of the group's rappers and vocalists.
As they worked on their debut album, Lauren continued to pursue her acting career. At age 17, she appeared on the daytime television drama As the World Turns. A year later, she appeared in a prominent singing role in the movie Sinister Act 2, Back in the Habit, starring Whoopi Goldberg. The film was a breakout for Miss Hill, who contributed to the soundtrack. Once she joined college, she tried balancing her school and performing career until freshman year when the Fugees signed a major deal with Rough House Records. In 1994, the Fugees released their debut album, Blunted on Reality. While it attracted some views, it did not establish the group's a presence in the hip-hop scene. For their second album, they wanted to improve, this time adding more reggae and old-school R&B. When their second album was released, the score immediately was a huge sensation. The record went on to win the Grammy Award for Best Rap Album, making Lauryn Hill the first woman to win in that category. The album featured three of their most famous tracks, one of which being Killing Me Softly with His Song, a remake from the 70s soul singer Roberta Flack, featuring some of Lauryn's best vocals. The song peaked at number 2 on US singles charts, number 1 in Britain, and brought the group their first Grammy for Best R&B Performance. The Fugees were now one of the biggest acts in the scene. A love triangle and financial disagreements made it hard for the Fugees to continue as a group. After Lauren and Wyclef Jean ended their relationship, the Fugees broke and Lauren went solo. In the tail end of the Fugees tour, Lauren met Rohan Marley, son of Bob Marley. In early 1997, Lauren and Rohan were expecting their first child, who was later born on August 3, 1997.
In 1998, Lauryn Hill debuted her solo album, The Miseducation of Lauryn Hill, thus becoming arguably one of the most influential women in hip-hop. In an interview with the Rolling Stones, Lauryn said, "I wanted songs that lyrically move me and have the integrity of reggae, the knock of hip-hop, and the instrumentalization of classic soul." Once released, Miseducation arrived at the top of Billboard Top 200 charts for 4 weeks and drew up at number 1 for 2 consecutive weeks. Lauryn Hill explored themes of love, black empowerment, social justice, femininity, motherhood, and more. At the 1999 Grammys, Lauryn Hill broke a number record, becoming the first woman to win 5 Grammys in one night. A number of magazine companies and films wanted Lauryn, but she chose to concentrate on her own solo career. By the end of 1999, 2 years into her solo career, her record sales and touring gained her nearly $25 million. In addition to her own schedule, she co-produced Carlos Santana's Supernatural, for which she received a second Grammy Award for Album of the Year. In the early 2000s, Lauryn Hill stunned the music industry when she announced she would step away from performing and devote her time to her family. Hill continued to write songs, and in 2001, she recorded a live performance for MTV for more thoughtful material, accompanied only by herself on an acoustic guitar. The show was televised the following year. Unplugged No. 2 was the name given to the live recording. Despite negative reviews, Unplugged opened at number 3 on the Billboard charts and sold over 1 million copies in the first 4 weeks.
Despite stepping out of the music industry, the influence of Lauryn Hill is still shown today. She's actively performing, announcing a reunion tour with the Fugees for the 25th anniversary of her debut album. Though many artists tried both singing and rapping, Lauryn Hill was the first solo superstar to truly master both. With all that said, thank you. This was Lauryn Hill.
I'm Taylor.
And I'm Natalie.
And this was
CDSTV. The girls just have fun. The boys, we make noise. The girls kiss the girls. I got the kids. All the colors are alive.